The only question I ever thought was hard was, do I like Kirk or do I like Picard? If you're too white nerdy, you've come to the right place. This is SIBO TV live with map number two, Team Prospect versus Selfless. Dust Pistol Roundabouts go underway. I think Dust is gone. I scared him with my horrible humor. That's all right. If you missed the first map, that was DE Cash, 1611 for Selfless. Prospect doing a much, much better job than we might have expected, and certainly a better job than we gave them credit for. Sinar, Josh RT, and Maka specifically dropping 20Ks, all three of them, last time around. Relics Hero of the Day on Cash. Question is, can Prospect turn it around and take victory on Dust to their own map pick? If they don't, they're going to be out of this qualifier right here in the round of 16. Winner advances. Third map, if you're curious, is going to be Inferno. With the pistol round underway, we've got Selfless setting up. All five players basically giving up a whole lot of map control. Grouped up towards long. Mainline's going to drop a smoke on Xbox and work his way up to split the A site. You got to deal with the players at long, though. Emote already dropped down inside the pit. Basically preventing Selfless from working their way out whatsoever. Finally, there it is. Uber dropping out, taking emote out, also dropping Maka. So now McNutty's going to be pinched off on two angles, having a fight with Mainline and Cat and Short, and deal with all these players up top. Not able to finish the job. Mitch with bomb, going down. Sinar on the retake. Now we see Sinar doing some amazing clutch work last time around. He's going to need four. Trouble is, everybody knows exactly where he is. The three guns trained on this position. Mainline jumping up. I think he spotted Sinar, knowing that he's still in this position. Sinar drops a nifty down. Terrorists win. Mitch with the delayed trade, giving Selfless that all critical first pistol round win. Looking at the purchases. Prospect gonna force off. They actually buy two scouts. That's gonna be Sinar and Emode. Let's see where they end up going with that. Sinar trying to pick down mid, and Emode might have been some confusion right there. Emode ends up working his way down towards long and then works his way towards mid. So it's actually double scouting down mid. If he works his way forward, spots one. Ooh, does some damage to Emode. Not able to find the headshot just yet. But that does give Mainline the confidence to start working his way on forward. Immediately taking mid control and splitting the defense. Three players all clustered up here. Josh tries to retake a little bit of position. They're going to drop the mid to B smoke and then set up at cap. But watch for Uber with the bomb down towards B tunnels. Doubles want to sell out a fake at the A site. May have canceled the threat though. Uber starting to work his way back off A. Bomb drop. McNutty coming up big on a flank. Mitch is able to go ahead and turn around. Take the kill instantly. And Relic on the other side of Xbox. Josh RT here to reload. Picks one off. Nifty. Able to escape with his life. Beware the jump scout. Two taps. Leaving Mainline now all alone. Do some work with that SMG though. He finds himself trapped in a corner though. Josh RT baits himself for his teammate. That's going to allow Maka to go ahead and pick up the kill. That was four for Josh RT. And Prospect pick up that vital trade. One and one. Effectively canceling the pistol round.
Yeah, that was a big quad kill there from Josh RT there, to say the least. Hit some nice scout shots and kind of steals a round away early from Selfless, who are looking to get that 3-0 start. It's not going to happen now. They will have to upgrade their pistols here, see if they can't make another go at it. They will not invest too heavily. They don't reckon to go into armor or anything like that. They want to make sure that they can still, you know, buy pretty soon.
I see emotes pushed up real close at long A. Selfless, not investing too heavily into this round at all. They're still able to go ahead and creep out towards mid. Oh, beware Maka playing way back. I guess that's back corner of CT, where he ends up picking off Mainline, trying to find information at long. Now it's just going to be the pincer on A site. Trouble is Emote is super close. Left out long.
And so Sutless now with just four members left. Nifty trying to bring that bomb up the catwalk. A couple players here right behind. But they got to deal with McNutty, who's still here at Goose. Maka on the slope. They still have a tough defense to crack here. Mitch is going to go for it. He's going to drop down the CT spawn, but he is going to get caught by Maka. And yeah, this is getting cleaned up right away.
Yeah. Uber just goes for it. YOLO straight onto the A side, hoping to get a plant. But there's, what, two, three CTs in position, including one that I think was sitting at Goose, finishing the job. Not a heavy investment, though, of course, for Selfless that time around. Trouble is, by losing that second round, they still have virtually no cash. They didn't get a bomb plant. In fact, they, yeah, zero bomb plants so far for Selfless. They charge in on another eco. Flashing into the B site, Josh Harty completely blind, still able to go ahead and pick up the kill on Mitch. And that shot's just enough to pull Selfless off the B site, and they fall back to mid, make another decision.
Yeah, the remaining four members are actually going to try to make their way up the catwalk, see if they can't punch this A-bomb site in and try to get a bomb down, but not going to happen. Absolutely wrecked here by McNutty and company, and so it will be a 3-1 start here for Prospect GG. Again, Prospect needing to win this map if they want to force a third. If they lose this, they will be eliminated, and Supples will go on to the quarterfinals to meet up with the winner of Vault and Energy, I think.
Well, first gun round now underway. AK-47 IAWP actually coming out in the hands of Nifty. This time around, lots of utility as well. Nifty's going to be opting down mid from Suicide. Super dangerous, but it might pay off big because Emote and Maka are charging straight down. Cat Mitch watching the angle, picks up one, holds the spray. Maka's able to finish it off. Expects Nifty to be right around the corner. What is this? Maka just mopping up the mess.
My. That's so disappointing because Selfless, they sniffed that out. Nifty jump spotted with the op and he saw that push coming cat. So Mitch knew it was going to happen. He was ready for it, but only able to get one kill. And somehow Maka comes up with three. You saw that Nifty tried to push Subblade there to try to get the trade on the Maka after Mitch and company went down, but it did not work at all. He got destroyed. So it's been a tough round on Selfless, but they did get it back into a 2v2. So this is still winnable. And they catch a guy right here at middle. That's going to be McNutty. They get him down a little bit, and they get some information. They're going to be able to make their way out long A now. There is no op to watch cross or anything like that, so they should be able to get into the A site and get a bomb plant. It's actually going okay now.
Smoke. Yeah, cross smoke. That's going to take Maka out of the equation, at least temporarily. Maka's already pretty hurt, though, down to 39 HP, spamming through the smoke. Mainline's on site.
Ooh, there was a gap in that smoke, so Mainline actually took a lot of damage. He's actually going to die to the fire right after the plant, so it's all on Uber. I think he may have planted for him.
I hope
still
going to
be difficult, though. Yeah, it is planted for Uber and Pit.
Oh,
oh wow, God, though. Didn't nasty. Matter, did it? McNutty just takes his head off. Wow.
Yeah, that was nasty. Just walks out there, barely spots the top of his head. AK-47 right there.
One could say he gave him a McNasty.
Yes, he did. Another 4-kill round. That's Maka.
Yeah, that was so big that Maka got 3 frags in the middle like that. That was insane. And Relic's the guy who was like the MVP in the last map. 0-5 right now. Nifty also not doing so hot just yet. Another slow start from Selfless, just like Cash. But will they be able to repeat that recovery that they had on Cash to ultimately win the map? Is going to be the real question here. Is they're going to slow things down a bit?
I wonder if it's more difficult in a way for a team like Selfless to play a relatively unknown group like Prospect. You can't really study, you can't really anti-strat these guys. You just have to learn and adapt as you go.
Well, to be fair, on Dust 2, it's kind of...
There's really only a couple of ways.
Yeah,
to
I mean,
the game, isn't
it, exactly. There's not too much to really even think about here. It's about having a guy at long A, understanding whether or not they're playing long or whether or not they're stacking cat, getting that information, and getting, you know, stairs control like Uber has, and just kind of playing off that if you want to go for A or mid B split. So it's all pretty straightforward. I don't know if it hurts them too much on this one. Maybe it did have an effect on them on cash a little bit, but they still weathered the storm and got through with the W. But they've had a rough start here on Dust 2 thus far, but it's looking a little bit better this time. They have a 4-on-3 with the bomb down on the A site. I think that a 4-on-2, Nifty catching the flank. So this is looking a lot better.
Yeah, it's super tight. Money not looking good for Sinara, but Mako with 7.8k, so even if he loses his gun, he's still in a decent position himself. They are going to go ahead and apparently go for him. Mako taking a couple of pot shots here. Relics watching the angle. If Sinara doesn't flick right, which he shouldn't, yeah, it should be a nice free frag for Relics. Spot in the barrel of that gun. And with that kill, that's enough for Mako to go ahead and fly back, getting the heck out of Dodge with an AK in hand.
So Selfless finally getting it around here. Still plenty of money though on prospects to buy next round. Money in the meantime for Selfless quite low, so they can't really give chase because they can't really afford the rebuys.
Terrorists win. First frag really coming out with Emo. I think every single round I've seen Emo playing the exact same spot, pushing up close left long doors every single time. Selfless starting to catch on to it. Walking out, pre-firing.
Double op setup now going to be in effect here for Prospects GG. JoshRT going to have it along with Mako, so no McNutty. So weird. I guess maybe McNutty just ops T side, and on CT side it kind of floats around. I'm not really sure, but Relics just pushing through the fire, able to get the entry on the Sayonara, so that's a big kill to get. Opened up the B-bomb site, now they have a 4-on-3.
Yeah, smoke's going off, so that's going to keep Mako just on the outside. The way it's on his teammates to come falling back in. Mitch has got tunnels covered. Mainline Uber Relics, every entry completely covered. Should not be takeable.
Yeah, if retaking
they play their cards right.
Yeah, retaking B so hard, especially a man down. We talked about this in the first series tonight. Not something you can really wrestle with too well. You see mainline push out. It's going to be a free frag there from Mako with the op. But other than that, the round has been won. They're just looking to save their guns now here on prospects. And as when Relics first came onto this team, he was supposed to be kind of a second entry with Uber, was like the original game plan. Now that things have changed, he's taken a more lurk role. But even on that round, you see he's able to still get out there and be aggressive with that rifle and get the entry when it's needed. So that's a lot of the reason why you see Selfless kind of mix up their setups a lot, is because they have riflers who are capable of, you know, playing more passive, but also have experience doing a little bit of entry work. And when the spawn is right, you gotta count that guy in front of you to find the kill and lay down the groundwork for the round, and Relics does it. Really big kill for him.
Yeah, I mean, essentially it was just a one-man entry at the B site for Relics, which makes.
And he's had a rough half up until that point. You know, that was a big round for him to, you know, get on the board.
Quite the opposite of what we saw last time around, where Relics was constantly the hero. You're gonna see the boost looking into tunnels. This might work out because Uber's working his way down towards lower tunnels. Could be spotted out.
Oh, I miss. Top shot is missed. They will go ahead and fall back. They'll still hold pretty aggressive positions on cap, but because they did that, mainline nose long is clear, so he'll go ahead and take it for himself.
These three players all grouped up on cat.
Yeah, I guess Emo wants to bunch up with him since he's on just a pistol.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to take that long range firefight with a pistol, that's for sure. Trouble is, he's going to have no choice. Yeah. Three players now with the bomb. Grouped up at long. Relics also watching the flank.
This is just a good read by Selfless. They knew that it was a cat stack. They knew they could take long, and now they have a lot of numbers out here. They can just get across to A. This could be another round of the bag for them, as you are going to see the smokes being set up.
Also going to be a molly onto the site. This shouldn't be a factor for Emo. Oh, Uber. Picks up one kill. I think he actually worked his way out towards mid and into CT. And in that position, he's being extremely disruptive to the defense. Josh RT stuck at B site, knows he can't push Uber, and then Relics is going to come working his way on in.
Relics, though, on the lurk, able to stop Josh RT from saving that op until Selfless. They've tied up the game right away. So they don't let it get too crazy like they did on cash before recovering. They get right back into the game early on. Money is low for Prospect GG, so they're going to be on just an upgrade pistol buy for the most part. So Selfless is going to have a great opportunity here to go ahead and take the lead for the first time this game. Well, I guess they did have one for a brief moment after winning the pistol round, but since then they've been playing from behind, but no longer the case, because they will have a double op for themselves, actually. Mitch going to be able to take the second op. I guess he had a good spawn. Try to use that. But look at this. All the pistols are actually going to push long A with four players. Actually get the kill onto Relics. They'll be able to pick up an AK for that. However, Selfless smartly backs out of there. And is now actually heading mid to B. But there's no smoke on CT spawn. And all these prospect members have rotated there with these pistols.
Well, the smoke finally ends up going down. They're just going to have to deal with Josh. Our team, Mitch, just walks in single-handedly trying to injure.
Oh, wow.
Tech 9, crazy spray all over. Panic spray. Still able to go ahead and pick up the kill. Smoke's down. Bomb's down.
Yeah, so 4-on-4 situation. Prospect going to go for it. They're just on pistols. They have not much to lose trying to go for this, but so far, Selfless has put a stop to it. Only Signer left with that one AK that they picked up from earlier. They would have get one kill here, but now he's in a 1v3. You're going to be difficult for him to do much more, and Mitch will take him out with the op. Two kills there on the round for Mitch, as it will be 5-4 in favor of Selfless.
And again, we're seeing lots of cash on hand for Selfless. Even after the purchase, they got two players sitting just on top, or just under $10,000. That's with two AWPs on the board as well. Both teams double opping though. Check this out. So it's gonna be a full-on battle of the oppers in round 10.
Absolutely, as we are gonna see Uber pushed out of long A, so not be able to get any real information there. Meanwhile, JoxRT has gotten tagged, I'm guessing by one of the ops through the smoke at middle. Might have been Relics or Nifty. I'm not sure which one did it, but JoxRT going to be a bit weaker now. I think he's one playing behind the double stack boxes, as it will be potentially a mid-B split here for himself. It's not really sure. Nifty going to get the op pick on the cat. They may just try to look to work into A now a little bit now.
There's one A pick. JoxRT typically being on B side. He's starting to work his way back towards the A side of things, so they've got three players to deal with over there. Mainline watching the flank, Relics watching mid. No decisions just yet.
They put that smoke up on Cat almost as if they want to try to do some type of boost op pick, but JoxRT reads it. Able to get the kill there onto Nifty, so that is not going to pan out so well. But they still do have a 4-on-4 at the end of the day, and they do have JoxRT very low on HP here in CT spawn. Mainline just missing the spam, finally lands it though, and now they have the main advantage right back. Relics makes it even better here. Uber gonna capitalize on that at long A, and now this round's in the bag for Selfless.
Yeah, just a beautiful wrap right there. JoxRT though with that read, brilliant shot. Unfortunately, Selfless is able to get all the entries that they need. Walking right around the corner. Sinav is gonna be the last man standing with super low cash. They're at max loss bonus. Getting 3.4, not enough to get a full buy as the CTs this time around.
So I'm
not
here.
Gonna save it.
Yeah, so this is five rounds in a row now for Selfless to get the 6-4 lead. Money again, very, very tight here on prospects. Gonna likely have to go from another pistol upgrade round, which means Selfless can go ahead and work towards 7. They have plenty of bank now. You got even a guy here on 10k post buy. It's gonna be Nifty. A couple of guys at high 9k after buy as well. So they're sitting pretty at this point over here at Selfless.
Again, a little bit of cat side short aggression from McNutty and Maka. They're not gonna push all the way out. Emo leaving long unwatched, and I think this is the Achilles heel for Prospect at this point. They leave long unwatched when they're on these ecos, but this might actually pay off. Check it out. McNutty and Maka now on a big flank. Relics is watching the angle. Able to pick up one. Should expect a second. Still flicks over. Picks up one more. And the only person left on A site dust is going to be Emo.
Yeah, and so Emo will get picked up there by Mainline, and then AK will be picked up here by Sinar. They were eventually able to get Mitch down inside the D tunnel, so they'll be able to roll that AK over perhaps, but there is still Relics, it looks like, lurking over here at middle, who could potentially stop that from happening. Even Uber has gone out for the hunt, and I mean, there's plenty of money here on the Selfless players to go for this, to try to make sure that no guns get saved. Make it a little bit harder on prospects, who will have enough money to buy next round, but this still could save him a little bit of money if they can keep this AK.
Relics is really close. Miraculously takes the kill on Sayonara before he gets traded out by by Josh. All the CTs down. As Doubtless now go up by 3.
They're doing a great work here at Prospects. It's going to be back onto a full buy now. McNutty is going to have the op now on the CT side by himself rather than Maka or Josh RT. So, again, they have been kind of passing it around over on that team. See if they can do anything here at middle. They are going to nade the cross, kind of denying vision for Nifty, and they'll get the smoke out here as well. They're actually going to get aggressive. They're going to try to do a little bit of a boost here on top of the Xbox, look for a pick. And they also going to get aggressive here on B tunnels, and Emo going to find 2 kills in the bomb. Wow.
Yeah, that's huge. That's a lot of information, and now you see this full-on rotation coming in. Maka's going to watch mid, and then the rest of them just group up and smoke off B tunnels so they can get some really solid defense positions. It's going to be really hard for Selfless to retake control of the bomb.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's really not much that Selfless can do. The bomb is down in such a hard spot to deal with. They are going to send Mitch out long A to see if he can't backstab someone, but everyone's focus is right here at middle in the B tunnel, so they're not really going to be able to do a whole lot. Nifty's the only guy that's anywhere near the bomb right now with this op, but he's smoked off for now. Relic's trying to meet up with him here from lower, perhaps. Knows he has to worry about middle. Might even come out here and check it. It's the kill.
Relic's with these flick shots, man. I'm telling you.
His aim has been on point, and they catch McNutty as well. So now they have a 3 on. There's no way that DCT should lose this round. Oh my, though. Their man advantage has been given up. Oh, is he really? Oh, come on.
Okay, so now it's just one. Sinar. Sinar has been the best player on Prospect so far.
Wow,
but
dude.
He's not going to win the 1v2. Picks up one for his trouble, but Mitch finishes this thing out. Selfless. My. I mean, okay. I get it. Selfless sets up, and they're like, hey, let's look for a couple of frags. Make it costly on them, and then if it looks good, maybe we can go for it. And then they get all the frags.
Can't lose those rounds if you're Prospects, man. Not when you're trying to make a comeback. It's unforgivable. I mean, I guess I can somewhat understand how they lost it when it became a 2v3. Like, they tried, like, at that point, you had to go for the play and kill Nifty, right? Because you know you're about to get pinched in from lower tunnels and perhaps even through B site. But look at this, they tried to go through a B push through a smoke, and Sinar absolutely destroys them. Nifty able to get a kill. Please don't tell me they're gonna lose another 5-on-2. Or 5-on-3 rather. Not like this. Come on. Come on,
it
Prospects.
Could happen.
You got it.
Could. Nifty knows something's going on, but he doesn't realize Maka's right around the corner. He busts the barrel. And then is McNutty gonna walk into his doom?
Looks like he's not. He's gonna go ahead and back off. But that bomb is, this is a very similar scenario. Bomb down, difficult spot. Prospects a couple of men up, but now they're just one man up, and they should win this round. But after seeing what happened last round, I can't count on it.
Who knows? Oh, man. There's Relics doing Relic stuff. Sinar now out. Josh RT and McNutty left. We've seen Relics just walk into the B site solo taking it in the past. Nifty's going to
take it. Imagine the fail fishes in chat that are about to drop. If this round goes to Selfless after what we saw in B-Tunnel's last round, hear me.
Nifty's got a whole lot of information at this point, realizes, okay, they're definitely both inside the B-Site, mm-hmm. and they can do this nice split push. There's the first pick with AWP, flicks over. Relic sacrifices his life so that Nifty can pick up a 4K.
Oh, man. So, again, it's understandable that they lose it when it gets to the 2v2, but it should never even have gotten to that. Right, I mean, Sinar gets a 3K spray down. It was a 5-on-2. They somehow lose it. That's insane. I mean, props to Selfless. They're making plays. Nifty's hitting insane shots with the op. You got Relics. He's had some big plays. I mean, they're doing the work on Selfless, but, I mean, Prospects are kind of just giving it to them. And after losing 2 rounds in a row in that fashion, you almost wonder if there's anything left in the tank over in Prospects. They're probably drained by now. Just losing these rounds in such crazy ways despite the heavy advantages they've had.
Yeah, at this point, Selfless is banking on Prospect being on an eco, which they are not. They've actually forced up, but they just charge in to the B site. Relics gets dropped down instantly, but it's too late. They've already got the bomb, and Mitch getting aggressive, walks right on out, spamming through the smoke, spots the player, and then Mainline goes ahead and picks up the spare, taking us up now 10-4. 10-4, good buddy.
I can't believe it's gotten to this. So many chances for Prospects to reel the game back in, and they've blown every one of those opportunities, and now Selfless is up 10-4. Auto snipers and ops are out. Time for someone to get run through the blender here at middle. It's gonna be Sayonara, but actually not that bad. I'll take that. I mean, he did take some damage, but it could have been much worse. Holy crap, do they not know this guy's out in B right now, Relics? Oh, they do know, okay. Okay.
Taking a page out of the Fnatic playbook, just not doing very much good at all. Oh, it's now going to smoke Sayonara off. Sayonara flashes himself out. Emote also getting his friends out long, and that's going to be very, very costly for him. Bomb dropping in. I guarantee you, Josh RT is going to flash himself in. No, he doesn't. Hang back.
Mainline, was that necessary, my man? Just that, take all that damage. I guess it didn't matter, but... What are you on for in the last part of this round? Last round of the half.
The aggression coming up against Nifty. They know he's here. He's dropping all these flash grenades. And even with that knowledge, Nifty's able to pick up one and then two at the end of the round, finishing it with three.
Look at that frag distribution over there on Selfless. The four frag spread from top to bottom. Yeah.
Yeah, wow. They're completely even Stevens over here.
Looking over here at the other side, Emote, he went 4-19 on map one. He's 4-12 right here on map two, so he's definitely had a tard series. No doubt about that. Had Sayonara, who was so big on cash, not doing as well here. Josh RT Maka's still doing pretty decent. Again, though, I mean, in all honesty, that half really came down to the two rounds that they lost there, where they had like they had a 5-on-3 with the bomb down in B tunnels. They lost that. They had a 5-on-2 with the bomb down in B. They lost that as well. If they win those two rounds, they would have been able to avoid some saving, perhaps, that they had to do towards the end with some force buys, and they probably could have wound up with a pretty decent half from their CT side. I mean, this map is slightly T side, so imagine if they win, like, two of those two rounds they should have won, and then they win, like, one more, and all of a sudden they would have been at 7, which would have been perfect for CT side Dust2. That would have been totally fine, but now they only have 4 rounds. Selfless up to 11. With the pistol round victory, they'll start waltzing into a big lead and likely a one-sided win.
Well, scoreline 11-4 puts a lot of pressure on Prospect going into this pistol round, and clearly they're planning something. They're up to no good. They got 3 decoys. Smoke and a flash and an HE grenade. They are spawned. Looked like they were spawned 4B. I'm going to charge that direction, but Uber pushing on up. Is he going to come up big or not? He gets charged on all sides. Mitch walks in, drops 1-2, and then he finds the bottom one. Okay, we can just push every single angle, and yeah, that'll work.
Yeah. So 12-4 now for Selfless. They will go ahead and upgrade. We will see the 4 spider prospects, as they didn't have a bomb plant that round, so they don't really have anything to save up for like a third round buy or anything. So pistol armor's out. Scout on the Sayonara.
I don't think those grenades were used either. So
oh wow,
Selfless gets gifted a little bit.
Or Sayonara. Sayonara didn't even make out a spawn, man.
Yeah, that was rough.
A tough break.
McNutty also getting tagged up by Nifty.
And Nifty did take a little bit of damage himself, but still the main advantage here for Selfless, as we are going to see Anka working long A a little bit here by himself. Bomb still down in T-spawn, the player is still peeking it. They're now going to be pushing catwalk here with Uber.
Yeah, Selfless pushed all over the place though. Look at this, mainline. Yeah. Uber.
Oh, that's a 1D. That's a big 1D too. That really kind of crushes this push from Selfless. Like you said, they were pushing pretty much all areas of the map. They still have a guy pushed in the lower B that's going to be mainline. They do have that info. I think they have the scout Nifty watching long A. So you might have a chance to, you know, get the information here pretty early to allow that rotate to set in. There is a player right near CT spawn as well, but they do have a main advantage on prospects, so they still have a good chance at bringing this thing back in.
With 40 seconds on the clock, I think mainline's realizing it's not going to be B, starts working its way towards mid. Mitch has already left mid open, so they will have a little bit of a fight on their hand. It's all up to Nifty. He's got to get some sort of a kill right here. Josh RT, P90, around the corner, just sprang. Nifty says, I'm getting the heck out of there, drop down low.
Not a bad idea either, but a nice nade comes and taking Emo down very low on HP here. But I mean, Prospect, they still have decent positions, and they got the bomb down.
Know that Mitch is over here. Oh, Mitch takes one, take two. And then there's McNutty at long range. Gonna be able to take the one kill now. Nifty. Oh, Nifty was able to jump.
Not much you can do. Not much you can do, and McNutty's got a scout and pit like that. But still, that was kind of dangerous. I mean, Selfless almost stole that one away, despite the fact that Prospects had a pretty nice advantage there. Mitch almost doing some big work to bring that thing back in. So it will be 5-12. We do have a pause. Apparently there's some ping issues here for Josh RT, so they're going to take a technical pause. Try to sort that out.
Well, this is the score line that I was expecting back on Cash.
Yeah, it's true.
I mean, just a quick recap for you guys just joining us. This is map number 2. Map 1 was Cash as chosen by Selfless. No surprises there. The surprise, though, was the fact that Prospect gave them quite the run for their money. Ending the first half up 9-6, and then struggling with their T side to finish 16-11. Sayonara, definitely the man to watch on that map. This time around, not so much. In fact, he's second to bottom frag.
Trying to think here, you know, if Selfless does have a real chance to make the comeback happen or not.
Well, it was big to get that last round, right? I mean, that essentially resets the money for Selfless. They started forcing up fairly aggressively, got the two scouts coming out, three players with the armor, and a Molly in Nifty's hand. And I don't recall, where's Nifty been playing? He's sticking with A-Sight.
Ooh.
Yeah, good night, McDonny. Insta-tapped with the scout of Mitch. How you turn it around.
Yeah, big kill there to open things up as it was another force here from Selfless. Not backing down, wanting to buy up right away. Normally, you know, when you win pistol, you lose second round. It's kind of a double save situation, but Selfless not going to do it. They're not going to back down. They're going to feel confident here and get these upgrades, and they do get the first kill, as you saw. The Prospect needs to be careful. Your nice pop flash, though, going to push Mitch out in CT spawn and grab that kill, so really well done.
Uber and Nifty not moving one bit. They're super pushed up by Cat. Mainline Relics also.
Gambling. Recycled that mid-control. Scout, by the way, and they get that scout that Mitch fell.
Josh RT spots Nifty just peeking around the corner, gets threaded out. Emote makes a secondary trade, and that is actually going to be a sight. He doesn't realize it just yet, but the teammates are falling in. Smoke keeps Mainline and Relics pushed back. Should be no problem on the bomb plant for Prospect.
Yeah, definitely there. I made it all up Cat already. They're going to get the spawn down inside the site. There are two scouts still in play from Selfless to retake with him. Mainline will get long pretty quickly. But I'm not sure if they're really committed to this. They may, like, they're not going to have anything next round except for maybe these two scouts. So maybe they want to try to roll it over the next round. It seems to be the case.
Yeah, you see them both backing on off. Mainline watching.
Yeah, so the gamble doesn't really pay off for Selfless here on the force buy, but it's okay. There's still plenty of rounds separating them from Prospects, so they could kind of afford to take a risk like that. Even though it didn't pan out, they're still, you know, not hurting too much economically.
I mean, we haven't seen a whole lot from Selfless's defense so far, but I think in all three rounds, we've seen Selfless pushing out at various different angles of the map. This time around it was the Cat aggression, and they left long completely open.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of pushing. We'll see how the first gun round goes. Maybe they'll fall back towards more of a standard style of play.
We are going to see AKs out here. Four Prospects, including a P90 Stone Josh RT. There are some P250s bought up. Those two scouts have been carried over. Looks like it's going to be a pretty heavy B rush here from Prospects right away. Mitch going to be here just with the pistol. He's getting pushed in. Mainline has rotated with that scout into the window. He's going to get hit out by a Molotov. And yeah, Prospects just sweeping through at this point, not having any trouble at all taking the site. And this round's probably in the books.
Should be. Uber Relic still hanging out of the scouts. Nade's going to drop one of them, but the scout is recovered by Nifty, and then they are hightailing it out of there. Almost flawless round right there. The only one that gets dropped was Josh RT. I was a little worried about Josh RT, though. He ended up charging in ahead of his teammates. A little bit too far ahead. If he was dropped instantly, there'd be nobody there to trade with. Not going to be a factor, though.
Yeah, indeed not. So it will be Prospects pushing this to 7. They're trying to mount a little bit of a comeback here, but Selfless, they're going to have their economy caught up soon. They still don't have the best money right now, but they could put these scouts to use again. They could afford some M4s and some other players if they want to go ahead and do that now. Be curious to see if they want to go ahead and just get 3 M4s behind these 2 scouts, or if they just want to upgrade pistol again and like push stuff. And just kind of make sure they get their economy like really settled before they go for a full buy.
That's what they're
doing.
Seems
to be the case, yeah. Not a bad idea. Again, they have a lot of breathing room here, right? I mean, they still have a decent lead. No need
That's a tough call because they're all sitting on $4,000. So you could certainly argue, make a very convincing argument to go ahead and buy right there. They're going to push all over the place. Emote watching. Oh, he's going to miss the spray though. Still gets one kill. Sees the gun of mainline going off. And there you go, Emode. Confidence boosting 2K.
Yeah, he's definitely had a hard night when it comes to the stats, but able to deal with that aggression there from Selfless, and so Prospects well on their way to an 8th round here. Those 2 scouts are still out for Selfless, but so far they haven't really had much impact. Emode has been taken down to pretty low HP, but otherwise looking really good for Prospect here. They're going to be working their way up the catwalk with the bomb. There is one player inside the A-bomb site that is going to be Relics with the CZ, but they'll get pushed out, yeah.
Yeah, Relics now standing out in the open because of the fire. Gets spotted, and that leaves Uber isolated at the B. Psych bomb goes down. Uber's going to go ahead and take the fight out. I mean, no reason not to. We're going to see a solid full buy round coming up next time around by Selfless, and he's just trying to make it costly.
Yeah, try to see what he could actually find. He is going to get flanked by Sayonara, though, from B-Town. So he's onto it. Misses the shot, however. And so there you're going to have it. Prospect going to push it up to 8. They've so far secured all the rounds since the pistol. But, yeah, the full buy out in effect now for Selfless. They even have enough money to go double off if they'd want to, which is certainly viable on this map. And they are. It is going to be an op picked up here by Nifty, of course. And the second op, like, it might actually be on mainline. Not normally the guy you'd see second op. Usually it's been, like, Relics, maybe even Mitch to a degree, but it's going to be mainline this time. He will take it over towards the back of B, which is a great place to put it. Meanwhile, Nifty takes his over at long end to contest the push. Emo does make it to the blue bin, but everyone else has backed off. They're going to attack Catwalk.
Well, charging on in. Catwalk is actually not being challenged at all.
What?
With the exception of, what is this, Nifty?
I didn't even know you could spam that like that.
Okay.
I'll be honest. All right, I learned something new today. I thought that would be I guess he maybe hit the gun through the corner. Either way, it is going to be a 3-on-2 now. Bomb isn't going to make it into A site, but mainline did he? Oh, wow. What a shot.
Yeah, it's going to be so hard. They have to plant for cat because Nifty's down in position at long, and they back off mainlines. Taking the solo flight. Solo fight takes McNutty, and now it's Maka. Maka really has no choice but to push this issue. Oh, walked right into Nifty with the AWP, and then Nifty's going to go ahead and drop onto the diffuser. Lots of time, and he's got the kill, of course. What was
I honestly have never seen anyone kill someone through blue bin like that with an AWP. I've just never seen it happen. Again, maybe he just grazed the corner of it?
Yeah, it could have been.
Yeah, it had to be. I don't think you could just spam the whole thing. That'd be ridiculous.
I kind of want to go in a server now.
Yeah, I'm sure it was just the corner that he clipped him through. Either way, that was pretty ridiculous. Also, I was mistaken. I thought mainline hit a shot through the smoke on the cross, but he didn't. So that was like random reaction that didn't make any sense to probably people out there watching. As mainline going to get the opening pick on the McNutty here at middle.
Yeah, that's going to make it a little bit harder for Prospect. They still have guns. They still have some teeth.
They're also going to be in a tough way money-wise if this doesn't work out, I feel like.
Yeah, that's bad because Selfless is now 2 rounds away from match point.
Well, actually, I guess they still have enough saved up. So not
it'll
as big
as only be $1,900 coming in next round. Yeah, they got enough to buy. Just barely, though.
And I mean, you could definitely see them in a situation, though, where if Celtics gets to that point on the final round of the half, they probably wouldn't have so much to work with. So that's something to think about going forward. But let's not get too far ahead of ourselves. There's still a lot of time left in this round, and even though Prospects is a man down, they still might have a shot at this. Sinar has also been taken down really low here. They're throwing mid to be smoke. Trying to work up the catwalk. Nifty just playing it passively from the corner. Mainline will now join him watching the cross.
Mitch and Relics have pushed outside of B. They're going to meet Josh. He's holding the AWP. Washington was going to go ahead and back off. Both players fall into the B site. Just now, Evo's going to start pushing. But he gets spotted on out along with Sayonara. Man. That leaves Josh RT all alone.
Timing right strike, dude. There was a moment where Relics and Mitch actually both pushed outside of B to go middle. Yeah. And then Mainline had actually rotated really deep into A, so they almost had themselves a free B bomb site. But right as they went for the hit, Mitch and company doubled back, and they were able to secure it. Wow. But Maka has a chance to ace and win this one. Never mind. I don't know what I was thinking. There's no time. Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, if there was a little bit more time, maybe. I mean, that's four kills for Maka right there.
Yeah, it was kind of nuts, but trouble what a round.
He's butted against the timer. And you're right. That B-site was wide open. If they pushed maybe 2 seconds even earlier, they would have caught those players just out of position.
Oh. There has been a couple of crazy rounds in this game, especially in that first half, that 2v5 and 3v5 that Selfless One were pretty insane. And
that was round ridiculous.
Even that round was kind of wacky, but we are going to see Selfless now approaching map point. Prospects able to get a full buy this round, but if this doesn't work, next round when Selfless goes for the win, they're not going to have Jack diddly squat to work with. So this round is pretty much for the game. They have to have this work. They are setting up for what seems to be a huge long A push, but Mainline's going to get boosted up on top of Blue Bin. Maka not going to expect that angle, and so Mainline will get the opening frag right away. They back off, though.
Nifty has pushed all the way up mid. I thought it was going to catch these players out, but now as long as Mainline can hold him in here by Blue Bin, Nifty's going to be able to come in on the flank. Emote has no idea player's back here. Look at him. Shot in the back by a pistol.
Wow. That is so crazy. You know, it's just Prospects putting all their eggs in one basket, trying to go for a later long A execute, but Mainline boosted Blue Bin, able to get two kills. And then, yeah, like you noted, there was no presence mid, so Nifty just makes a crazy flank and grabs pretty much a free frag. And now it's a 3v1. And again, this was kind of their last chance because their money is so low now to get anything done before Selfish just went ahead and waltzed away with the series.
Mitch was doing a little jump spotting, toss of the nade, and that finishes Sayonara off with the spray, putting us in the match point now.
So, as she said, match point, and Prospects will only be able to work with some Tech Nines here. They do actually still have enough money for Maka to get an op, but everyone else is just on upgraded pistols and armor. Have a little bit of utility to work with, but not so much. They don't really have a great spawn to do anything long A again. They're actually going to take the spawn they had at B with McNutty and Sayonara. I'm not sure they're going to try to do like a really, really fast mid B with Maka just covering with the op from well behind. It seems to be the case.
Oh, the fast catch just misses the two players from Prospect walking around. They had to have heard him though. Relic peeks out, takes one, not able to take two. Mitch still alive, gets completely swamped, overrun by Prospect. So this is going to be bomb plant, no problem for Prospect. They've got the man advantage.
Yeah, they really do. And they have picked up a couple of guns here as well. They have an M4 on Sayonara, AK on Josh RT. So they definitely have a good chance to hold this retake off. I mean, Selva's going to be hard-pressed to make this happen. Again, retaking be so hard, and they're a man down, but it looks like they are thinking of going for it.
Whoa, RT! Josh RT with a crazy, like, walking spray through window. Still able to go ahead and pick up the kill. Simultaneously, the rest of the players fall. Prospect still in this thing. Eco Force, and suddenly they've got the cash to mount a real fight. Worse does. Selfless is broke.
Oh, yeah, they're super broke. They're going to be broke again next round, too. So that was a really big win for Prospects. Didn't see it coming. They just go really fast out mid and B. They catch the B players out, and they secure the round. And, yeah, like you said, Selfless not going to have a whole lot to work with. And there's a good chance now that Prospects can at least push this to 11 before Selfless buys again. And so there is an outside chance that this game
gets real, real close, and if Frost can put enough rounds together, they might even fight for an overtime opportunity. But to be fair, once Sutless got their money in order, they didn't seem to have any trouble winning rounds. They won three, you know, pretty much full buy rounds. So I think it's still pretty safe to say they'll be able to close this game out before it gets to OT. But like I said, there is that outside chance Prospects might be able to push it to the limits here.
Yeah, Selfless is banking on a B hit. They're playing this super close angle with Uber and Nifty and then Mitch sitting here back. It is they bait themselves, get whatever free frags they can, and then Mitch is going to come out and surprise. However, Prospect has backed away from the B tunnels. They've taken long control. Relic is spotting. Should know something's up at this point. And the rotation's fully underway. Nifty and Uber both going on big flank. No, just Uber. And then yep. Nifty's going to go up mid.
I mean, they know what's happening here over on Selfless. They don't really have the firepower to contest against it. Relic's not hitting the Deagle shots here. Mainline does get one kill, and Remote is down really low. That nade might finish Mainline off. Yeah, it does. Well placed. And so the bomb is going to go down here. It's a really fast flank at long, but it looks like Sayonara is onto it, so...
Emote's really, really low. Where is he? Sitting inside the site. So he might actually get picked off really fast by Nifty. Flash is ineffective. Selfless, no, they're not even going to go for it.
No.
Got P250s. They'll have to save next round.
Absolutely. I mean, they're just looking for exits at this point. Nifty, whoo! That's a nice little headshot there on the McNutty. Doesn't get traded out eventually. No one really exits long, so Uber's just going to try to go out here and chase now, but Sayonara onto it. But we'll be 15 to 10. And again, there's not much money here onto Selfless, so they will likely be saved again. They will upgrade a couple of pistols this time. I mean, they can afford to do that and still buy fully next round. So they'll give themselves, I guess, somewhat of a small chance of just going ahead and ending it now. But very likely that Prospects will go ahead and push this along a little bit further.
Yeah, they're going to get, what, $2,400 next round. So set a floor of, say, $2,500 with the exception of Nifty, who wants to hang on to as much as possible so he gets the AWP. That's why you're going to see him. With nothing but a USP coming out this around. Mitch doing work with the Deeg.
Not like this, Pat. Not like this, bro.
Can't lose it like this. Mainline pushing out aggressively as well. Before he ends up backing off. And look at this Prospect down two. They're going to have to fall back and really think about what they need to do next.
Ooh. Oh, Mitch got caught through the door. He was trying to get out of there. I thought he was going to get away, and that would give Selfless even maybe a chance to win this round. They still actually have a chance. Lux does have an AK picked up, but it's a 2v2, but he's so far away.
But he's like,
I don't know if he'll flank. Yeah, I mean, but will he get there fast enough for it to matter? He's hightailing it now. If Mainline can just stay alive on catwalk and let Relix flank, they actually could just win it here like this, and that would be so devastating.
Yeah, the pressure's on Mainline right here, but he's just going to go for the sneaky angle.
Really nice idea.
Surprise him. Maka suspects something, so it's really up to Relic to take this fight with the AWP 2OP. And the sneaky play by Mainline is not going to pay off either.
So Prospect, they do hold on. They do put that round away, and they do move this along. That was kind of scary, though. And now you think with Selfless on a full buy, they can get so close to winning a round with just pistols. I mean, their chances are looking pretty good to just end this thing soon with a full buy. But if they lose this, they're kind of back in safe territory. And that's when Prospect can actually push it to 13. So, they're, like I said, that outside chance of this maybe going to overtime is still there. It's only a single op this time for Selfless. Nifty will have it. He will take it over here. At the back of B, actually, so they're moving him around a little bit.
Be a distinct possibility. Bomb works its way down towards mid. No T control towards long. Uber thinking. No.
Is Relic's boosted? Yes.
Yeah, I think he is. Oh, this
could
be
a game changer. Yeah.
Because you can see right over the top of that smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Peeks up. Spots him, gets all the intel, even blind. Able to pick one off, and then Mitch peeks out to take the other two. That leaves Maka all alone. AWP clutch to win.
I don't see it.
Yeah, Uber's on a flank too, so he's in real trouble at this point.
Oh, yeah. This is pretty much a GG at this point, as
Relics in a big spot, and then what really happened, that was such a combination of things, right? Not only was Relics in that boosted spot, which is if goes unchecked can just win rounds single-handedly, but you also had Nifty with the out covering B tunnels, so Mitch didn't have to worry about that at all, and he could actually kind of use Relics as bait. Once they started getting shot at in the back, they kind of turn around to pay attention to Relics who's shooting them, and then Mitch is able to step out.